Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well. I hope you're having a great week. And as always, thank you for subscribing. I really appreciate those new subscribers and all my old ones too. So just going to be reacting now to a track by Julian Cope. This is taken from an album called Fried, and that was from 9th of November 1984. And the track I'm going to be reacting to is called Sunspots. I've never heard this before. In fact, I've never heard of the album before, Fried. And I've only ever heard one other Julian Cope song before, and that was Reward. That was quite a high tempo, if I remember rightly, with a great video to boot. So yeah, Sunspots was released in the UK, but sadly only reached number 76 in the UK, charts. Didn't hit the top 40, which is what most people in the UK would be listening to on a Sunday evening. Having said that, Julian Cope has a really interesting voice, if I remember rightly, and this actual performance is from a few years after the album, from 1987, and I think it may well be from Brazil, because I think it's from Rio, perhaps. I might be wrong. So yeah, without further ado, really looking forward to this, to see what Julian Cope's got to bring with his track. Quite an intimate audience by the looks of it.
This is called Sunspots. Sunspots, shaking there, walking around with my very best friend. I got a love sign in my head. I'm moving on with my very best friend. We look good, but I don't see you. Walking around with my very best friend. She looks good, fine to me. I'm in love with my very best friend. It goes away. Driving around with my very best friend. I got a love sign in my head. I'm moving on with my very best friend. We look back, but I don't see. Moving on with my very best friend. She looks good, fine to me. I'm in love with my very best friend. It goes away.
So I'm just going to pause it there for 2 seconds. I really like the sound of his voice. I don't remember his voice sounding like this on the track Reward, unless I'm just confusing myself there, or my memory's getting confused. But yeah, I love the sound of his voice. It's so deep, like a, I want to say, is it baritone? I love the guitar at the very beginning, and then that little keyboard break there, which I thought was like a flute at first, but yeah, it's what it can do with keyboards, I guess. It's a great song. It feels a lot different to Reward, and I'm really enjoying the live performance because I've only ever seen the video for Reward, so I had no idea how he kind of came across on stage at all. So I'm just going to wind his back. Yeah, I love that little keyboard break there.
It goes away, way, way, way out.
That was great.
Sunspots, and I drive around in my Harman gear. Drive along for a little while, I smile and I can look into my rear. Well, all the things that I was doing last day, they talk down the things, the places that we went yesterday. And GB Scots and all the places we went yesterday. So I move on a little slowly and I start to wind up. I say, I don't need this 12-string guitar anymore. I don't need this black leather jacket anymore. I just need to feel free and float. So I stand to my knees, turning round, and I can see you up into Bethlehem. And I can see her, I could see her. And I start to move around, start to move around and see her. And I start to see you, see her. Start to see her. My soul is running top. My soul is on her rear. My soul is right on top. My soul is on her rear. My soul is right on top. She's building up and I can't stop. Building up. She's building up. She just keep on. She just keep on. Just keep on. Just keep on. Just
that was Julian Cope from Sunspots, and that was really, really, really enjoyable. That was it's the first time I've actually heard that, and that was from the album Fried. I really think I need to check that album out. I wasn't really aware of anything else he'd done. And the other record that I do remember him doing, and I thought about it halfway through, was I think it was in about 1986. I think he may have had two records. One of them was definitely World Shut Your Mouth, which was really, really good. But I didn't know anything about this, the stuff he did between, I think it was about 1980 and 1986, 87. So yeah, this was a really, really pleasant surprise for me. And I just kind of thought about, you know, what track I could possibly react to from Julian Cope. And I just liked the title when I came across it. It said Sunspots. I think this song's about pretty much about having a friend of the opposite gender who you get along with famously, but you also kind of fancy a little bit. I think that's generally what it's about. And I think that maybe... because this is 6 minutes long, I would love to hear the actual album track, just to kind of see if there's any, if there's much difference between this live performance and that album track. So I'm gonna have to come back and have a listen to that. I'm definitely gonna have to have a listen to the album. Maybe react to another track off the album as well. So let's have a quick look at the lyrics. Sunspots, changing glares, walking round with my very, very best friend. I'm not sure what the context of sunspots, changing glares is. Walking round with my very best friend. I've got a love song in my head, strolling round with my very best friend. I look back, but I won't see, walking round with my very best friend. She looks good, fine to me. I'm in love with my very best friend. Sunspots, changing gear, driving round with my very best friend. I got a love song in my head, holding on to my very best friend. We look back, but I can't see. Moving on with my very best friend. She looks good to me, fine to me. I'm in love with my very best friend. I mean, maybe it is a platonic love, but I'm not sure if he's thinking about a friend who he actually just realizes he fancies. And I think you kind of go through moments with different people, especially when you're younger, where you might have friends of the opposite gender, and you hit a certain age where you're thinking, actually they're not bad, I could do worse. But I think even at an earlier age, you know that dipping your toe in that water may ruin a really good, possibly for life, friendship. This performance was wild. It was lots of energy, and his voice was just, I wouldn't say he's got an incredible voice, but I think what he's prepared to do with his voice really, really set the whole track off on this, because it didn't feel like vocal gymnastics. It just felt like a waterfall of sound, and it definitely created interesting vocals for this. He's got really good stage presence as well. I thought at one point he kind of got like a little bit of a scary face. But that was the image he was looking for in his particular song, to maybe take it from the friendly, happy friendship of a song to something a little bit less savoury, maybe. And I'm not sure what he was kind of simulating at the end. I can only imagine. I loved his performance on stage. And so I loved the guitars at the beginning, and I kind of felt them all the way through. And it felt very kind of grinding and raw. But that was kind of contrasted with the keys as well, which gave it that nice kind of floaty, happy sound. It's just a really, really good track. I would love to hear the album version. I'm definitely going to have a listen to it as soon as I'm done here and see if it's the same. 6 minutes long, it didn't feel 6 minutes long. His performance was great, as I've said, and I really, really enjoyed this. I didn't expect it to be like this. I don't really know what I did expect, to be honest, but I really hope that this doesn't get blocked either, because I love these live versions. And as much as you like the purity of the audio version, I think these live versions bring that extra dimension to my reaction anyway, because it gives me a little bit more to talk about, just even if it's just about the appearance of them. I noticed he was singing about a leather jacket towards the end, and he didn't actually have one, so maybe he kind of imagined he did have one, or maybe discarded that. I was curious. Little things like that bother me, but that aside, I did enjoy this track. Guys, let me know what you think about this track. Let me know what you think about the album, if you've heard it, and any more suggestions for Julian Cope, because I know there's that World Shut Your Mouth, which I'd completely forgotten about, and I'm sure there's another one that came after that. but that I cannot think of. But I'm sure if I heard it, I'd know it. Anyway, guys, take care of yourselves. Have a great day. Have a great week. And I'll speak to you all very, very soon.